And the footfalls of another wayfarer grace our ears. I'm delighted. I don't suppose you're traveling through Galette, are you? If so, I would not look too hard for anyone. There is not much left to find. Ah, it does pain me to hear the words of the non-believer. But as my God accepted the souls of Galette, so will he accept yours. It is a pity you did not see Galette's transformation. The fire, the blood, the screaming, all coalesced into a thing of wondrous beauty. There is no need to struggle. You will find peace and eternal rest in but a few moments. And in exchange, Balin will let us rouse his slumbering servant so that he may sow chaos and death throughout these realms. Generous Balin, praise be to you. Ugh.
The demons defile the land. The burnt skin of the world glows red with suffering. It is the deep gloam, and a pallor of death settles on the people of Amalur. Fires rage across the wastes. The only sound is whispered laughter. As the embers cool and a wind blows across the desert, life once more erupts from the husk of the earth, and the struggle begins.
So, you made it to our camp. After seeing how you handled yourself against the Testament, I was hoping you might. Those of us in camp trust each other, but aid is not as forthcoming. I will be blunt. The testament has taken something from me, and I want to recover it intact. But I cannot do it alone. My brother, Giran, they did not take him per se, so much as seduce him. He was a promising adept of the Scholia Arcana, and then one day he vanished. When I heard of the Testament's involvement, I feared the worst. I managed to track him here to Galette. Then I discovered just how large the presence of the Testament was in these marches. Excellent. I have resources at my disposal for a reward if we are successful. I have reason to believe that he is hiding in the ruins that run beneath the marches, this tomb of Ferragnus. I will meet you there. Hopefully, this cult has not sunk its claws too deeply into Garan's mind.